While Tony, who spoke last night, my husband, and I are here in Nagaland, it's the first time we've left our children by themselves without one of us with them.
그래서 이름이에 돈이쁘게서 의미니 지옥원이 의미하고 가만히 이럴 때 그래서 어하 되게 뭐 나가는 걸 모르겠어요.
So there's a slide. They would like to send their greeting to you.
어디구 메디우 버린데 야기구 메디우데스 제세야우에 슬라이크 부르겠어.
Most importantly, my father and mother are staying with their children in Malaysia, and my father in particular sends his greetings to you.
아부모아 주오니에 말레이시아도 이미 유명고 세바고 바우시리 아부 결루데스 세보르고 조세오.
He was able to visit Nagaland 2 years ago with my husband, and they delivered around 20 copies of my great grandfather's original writings to Nagaland seminaries and churches.
디지에디니에 호가당이 하고 홀홀이 마감이에 제게세 무수 기운도 어보자 그래서 특히 봐야 될 것으로서 경문 세가바 또 바뀌기 이제 경문 봐야 될 것으로서 세월이 나가랜드 바이블 콜레이션도 그러고는 그래서 지금 쓰려고
It was one of the highlights of his life, and he prayed very fervently that he could return.
我从这个就是不跟父母，马克思他读的这是列比亚，我读的听你那个那个查拜了。
So the picture behind me is our family.
아시아시아那边我有听过的。
And my children, my 4 children, send their greetings to you today.
아니요，你第一个人跟那个是谁？我读的是谁？
All of us have a unique story.
如果被对立，如果结果逆转。
Part of God's sovereign foundation in my story is that it connects with your story as a Ghana people.
啊，只有一路，你们说，啊，跟父母，这个告诉是，我只有生活里，我们明年，这一天的事情，这个。
Truly, our stories are woven together in a way that's supernatural.
如果朋友说，不能说你，如果这，这个生活，该啥的事，是个是这个。
It's God's story.
Okay, can you put Jerry?
In 1915, my grandmother, Dorothea Tanguis, entered the world. I'm the eldest great grandchild of Joseph and Mabel Tanguis, who served in Nagaland from 1913 to
1947.
我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的弟弟，我们的 love and longing for my grandmother Dorothea. She always longed to return to Nagaland, but was never able to. Instead, she prayed. So eating delicious curry dinners, marveling at Naga shawls, spears, and other Naga artifacts, and always praying for Nagaland was part of my early life. Grandma Dorothea shared of her parents' early arrival into Nagaland in
January 1913.
They traveled by steamer across from America to Calcutta, and then many days by train to Dimapur.
America nu ta 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 so nu nu vor mu ta 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 nu ta ma nu 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 vor de ze de ze ta se vor de ze chi.
And then they had 5 days by ox cart through the jungle and winding roads, finally landing in Kohima.
저기 접대무 미투 가리무 파서 저기 접대무 시도고 기회라고 그랬어.
I have a few photos that I was able to receive from my grandmother, which I am privileged to share with you.
아, 자, 힘으로 내게 보고 문에 뭐 아, 수고수 세게 보고 세게 살이 이렇게 세게 하고 부탁이 있어요.
You see here the old mission compound.
올리로 미션 compound 교회에
from 1913.
이제 뭐 그때 분위기를 세 지에.
And then early Angami believers.
사실 올리로 안강님의 대표님의 교회에 보면이.
Grandma wrote of her in her memories. I'm quoting. Dad built a bungalow where we lived, known as the Tankless Bungalow. There I was born, delivered by Dr. Ravenberg.
아자 투비 세계도 아이아이즈 그룹 무리야 뭐고 그게서 앞으로 기호가 쓰서 뭐고 비세 Tankless Bungalow이 기야 아 기호는 뭐 앞에 무리야 뭐 Dr. Ravenberg 앞에 무리에서 쓰고서는 썼어.
I can still remember with delight my room off my parents' room, and there was a veranda on the front of the house screened in and glassed in on one corner.
그 두 사람에서 아 기부요 아저 아프네요 기부기기 아 기부시요 하러 가봐야 뭐 바란다 기부지 뭐 바란다 뭐가 수수리 가봐 뭐 부기로 가봐요 가봐야 수수리 가봐야.
So these are a few photos of my grandmother as a young girl.
아자 공주기 해리 대희라 누구리에서는 이제.
She's playing with her dog Buster here in front of the old bungalow.
Well, for Buster is a fur. So you have to say that.
She wrote, "The house was built on a large hilly acreage with a large, beautiful view of the valley with mountains in the front. I loved the gorgeous sunsets."
Well, to be with your mother, Kiu, it's a beautiful day. No, Kiu, sir, no, well, it's a true Raja, so was a Kim, was a movie, only said, no, he killed the movie, she is here, also a Nisia, as a video.
Grandma had one older brother, Donald, who often went on village tours with his father. They would cover 200 miles on terrain on bicycles.
아차 그 부녀 이거 도노 이게서 이거 봐야 뭐고 아부지니우 르베게서 시베서 뭐 마일도 페디니에 지에 사이토누 르베게서 시베서야.
They saw amazing movements of God in many Naga villages with such a hunger for God's word and for teaching.
Ugo Rivesu, the Pinoka Uno City, Matsilisa, Nagamiera, Nagamu, Matsilisa, Sukosumu, Jorka Pinoka, Tie, the Pinoka, Tie, the Pass of Sava, the Hermer Visit, she is away.
Grandma continued, "Every afternoon, people would stop by for tea and babies served on the corner of this veranda, and here's where we entertained many visitors."
아차 버릇은 두피가 봐 무사경에 뒤손에 땡에 짜기 거리 뭐야 뭐 뛰어보노 원한다는 것도 뛰어보노 아 메카다고 니게 봐야 돼서 쓰면서 쓰는 이 뭐야 무슨 뛰는 되고 레소프트 소프트 쓰리야
Perhaps some of you may recognize this family, the next family.
이거 믿고 이거 시바니 시바니
Through my very close relationship with my grandmother, she imparted her love and vision to me, especially to see national Christians equipped and mobilized for ministry and missions.
Ah, so I got the rope. Get the news. There's a lot. Well, you see, there's a zero point eight years. So was a abuse. So was a receive. Mostly, but I mean, for him, yeah, it's a serious concern. You put that in his head, yeah. 주로 예토 무 이렇게 비유해서 접근 측에서 그렇다고 해서 그래서 아무리.
Along with Bible translation, equipping national local Christians was her parents' greatest passion as well.
Bible
She prayed fervently for the churches in Nagaland until her dying day. My great grandparents and my grandmother to so deeply impact my own purpose for life and calling into ministry. At the age of 7, in my local Baptist church Sunday school, I felt the Holy Spirit affirm my deep desire to serve the Lord someday in cross-cultural ministry.
Sunday school, the Messiah Arts Center, Mumabu, Kunyabu, Nipu, Yetsu, Yogas, Arts Center, Asi.
I eventually attended a Christian university and graduate school in missions, where I studied Christian leadership development and ultimately met my husband, Tony.
Christian University, Kunu, Lissaper, Moshi, Sunu, graduate here. Musashi, Sunu,
I had a strong sensitivity to God's call in my life, and often I would carry the weight of the world, the needs of the world on my shoulders. How can I do enough was often my thought. By His grace, over the years, God has shown me repeatedly that He wants me to simply be faithful to be who He created me to be, wherever He places me. He wants me to abide in Him and to enjoy and delight in the good works that He has prepared just for me. When you think of your own sense of calling in life, have you ever asked yourself any of these questions? Does my life matter? What should I do with my life? How can I best serve God? I want to be a good steward and invest my life in kingdom purposes, but how? We often look to pastors and counselors or teachers to tell us what our life should look like or what our life purpose should
be.
Or we even can look to personality tests and spiritual gift tests. As I've counseled with many people over the years in regarding their life and ministry, I've seen a lot of interest and willingness to serve, but often very little clarity of purpose or direction.
Okay, 선생님께서 주소 누가 보기가 내리게 내리 쓰다 자기 제 교리가 그래서 서고 맺음에 교회가 무무야.
This is particularly true for people going through transitions in life or in their ministry or in their work.
보하보시리 그녀에게 누 보리 함께 이모드쇼 이 제게 세야 그래서 서고 하하이게서 무무야.
My hope is that in the next few minutes I can give you a refocus or greater clarity and encouragement.
Ah, just I okay. Take us on the take us on the zero. Get put up a whole new how meant to be it will touch us even here because I have a very
you have a calling for the world to experience the glory and radiance of Christ that is abundant in you. And God is committed to show you your calling. Your calling is meant to be your greatest joy because it's what God created you for. God has been sovereignly at work in your life, orchestrating all circumstances. And I pray that some of the principles I share today will help you become more alert and oriented to your own calling for the glory of God. It's important for us first to look at the context of God's eternal story in order for us to understand our own stories and better steward that which He has entrusted us. Dietrich Bonhoeffer, a theologian from about 100 years ago, said, only in the Holy Scriptures do we know our own story.
Dietrich Bonhoeffer,
God has been authoring a story since before time began, and it's a story that flows from His loving heart and continues until now. In God's story, He is the creator of all things, and because of that, all creation reflects God's divine nature. Romans 1:20 says, for His indivisible attributes, namely His eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world in the things that have been made. All of God's creation display an aspect of His glory to the world. My great-grandfather Joseph described going on tour in the hills, crossing 200 miles of terrain, and he was just awestruck at the wildness and beauty of these hills.
Up until the day to get to the river, rëvegët të zezë ose të bidurja, mu po ki dzëtu bëdu, të cabu në, ku i di rëvegët zë, po ke mu gjithi të horë dhe të zezë ose zezë të bidurja.
Yet even with the breathtaking beauty of the Naga Hills before him, he wrote, people are the crown of God's creation.
Dhe po vori nga dhe një të cëtu, gjithi i ka cabu gjithi së të mu të mu, po të zëmësh, po të zëshemi, po e pujdu dhe zëtë të rjo,
this is because we are uniquely created in the image of God.
How have you come on where can you put can you put what's in this about?
Genesis 1:27 says, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him, male and female, he created them.
Che non per tutto il giorno non in se che per tutto il giorno non vuol che non mi è che non mi è se che non mi è.
Each of our stories within God's eternal story begins with the truth that we are created in God's image.
Ugo zio che per non per zio non che salvata Gesù si dirò ha che trovi zio ha ha che per non per giorno non ugo mi ugo che se si è su su è.
If you look at the painting on the screen, it's of Creation of Adam by Michelangelo. Notice that God is the one to reach toward Adam's limp hand to bring him life.
Michelangelo is a man.
God knelt down personally to create man and woman. He breathed into us the breath of life and stamped on us his very image as our creator. Unlike animals, we carry the image of God. We bear the nature of God, we reflect his attributes, and we act on his behalf. And we have a soul that will live eternally. At the same time, each of us is unique. There's no one like
you.
He's given each of us a unique fingerprint. No two are the same. All of you reveal God's image in a way that only you can.
No, but in your first view,
so as part of God's creation, each of us display an aspect of his glory to the world.
So that can be never put to the Google to the system, no other was I here. If you say it's a big city, Jesus is a good way.
The glory of God was revealed into creation, but as you know, as soon as Adam and Eve chose their own way in the garden, they fell from the glory in which they were created.
If you put to the system, no other was I here. If you say it's a big city,
the image of God was broken in them and they lost the intimacy with God that they had.
So that
So through Adam and Eve, our original glory was broken at the fall because we are born into sin.
Adam and Eve,
Romans 3:23 begins, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." We are fallen image bearers, and sadly sin blocks the glory we were created to reflect. Yet God, in His great love, launched the greatest rescue mission ever to redeem and restore fallen image bearers to the glory He intended.
There you can look up, okay, she is a rule, or get a rule, part of the citizens of Europe. They do the love, they put him, put him look, citizens, they need to do the love, suppose the Kamala, suppose the Kamala, you know.
Our glory is redeemed and restored through Jesus Christ, who is the full expression of God's glory.
Jesus Christ, no, Zayeta, Zilewa, Susa, Sedasalade.
Romans 3:23 continues, "We are justified by His grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus." Romans 8 says, "Therefore there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set you free from the law of sin and
death."
The moment we turn to Christ in faith, we receive a new and redeemed nature that becomes alive in Him. Through the indwelling Holy Spirit, the image of God in each of us is now. Reflecting back into God's story, there is an eternal story that God unfolds through the pages of Scripture. We are part of that. God pursues us in Christ in order to set us apart for His purposes and
glory.
1 Peter 2:9 says, "For you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for His own possession, that you might proclaim the excellencies of Him who called you out of darkness and into His marvelous light." God created us in His glorious image. And through our relationship with Christ, He sets us apart to proclaim who Christ is, the one who rescued us from darkness into light.
Mă Cristo să te rog de să nu poți să poți primi cum Cristo vie, să vede. Cu ochi la să te zini nu pot să fac pe zini să le dau sus să se să de gândi ce se iau.
And now as followers of Christ, he commissions and sends us out to reveal who he is to the world.
Mulțumesc! Și ține Iisus Hristos și zine să le gădă la cu ochi celor de că pe nu vezi ce ușurii că să hăbie Iisus Iisus le gădă la cu ochi celor de Iisus Hristos și zine.
While I was attending graduate school in Michigan, I learned another great commission verse from John 20:21.
Michigan, listen for the one to be, the ticket is a gazette verse the people.
As the Father has sent me, so I send you.
So it's real.
Jesus was the incarnation of God. Jesus incarnated his Father to our world by entering our humanity and dwelling among us. Now through Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit in us, we are able to incarnate or make Jesus real to our lives to those who don't yet know him.
Muncile cristala, multe misori cu lucrul din toate dar sau ceva. Vezi Iisus și nu se gândi, ochi lumea nu Iisus și nu se gândi, cu lasă mortele.
Matthew 29, verses, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you.
Matthew 29:30.
You've been pursued, set apart, and commissioned by Christ to reveal and reflect him authentically to the world around you and invite others into his story. I hope you can see that as a follower of Christ, there is a great significance and purpose to your life.
No, Jesus Christ is the one who is the one who is the one who is the one who is the one.
I want to take a moment to discuss what it is when we speak of God's glory.
Că pe nopo zaie că pungeți că pungeți unul ngu hapo sa nesimă.
Christians often talk about God's glory or doing something for his glory. In fact, glory is one of the most common words in the Bible.
Că pe lemie, Cristo mie, că pe nopo zaie să se zi cu seia mori, că pe nopo zaie la bucă să mă jucă să se spuia, că tole sânul, că pe nopo zaie
the Bible is a story that is concerned at its heart with the glory of God.
Că tot acela, că pe nu poți să iei sus pe cum că nu de zăpă să te poți să îndrumi.
Let's unpack a bit the meaning of glory and how it actually applies to us.
Să iei pe cel hoa, pe cel le bătsa bătsa nu hoa ugula cu cel ce te duci.
The Old Testament, which is written in Hebrew, uses the word kavod to express the idea of glory in relation to God.
Că tole să vedem nu, că vine din nu. Viața kavod, uideță, viața văsăia, mă hăbise, că pe nopă zăie, sus vața zăia.
And like most Hebrew words, it offers a word picture to clarify its meaning.
Mă ibrimi vie, nu vața e văsăia, nu vii, nevii, nevii,
the word kavod means weight or heaviness.
Kavod means heaviness.
An Old Testament connection to the weight or heaviness of God's glory is seen at the dedication of Solomon's temple. Second Chronicles 5 says that the temple of the Lord was filled with the cloud.
세계적인 예배로 그 인물로 쓰고 있다가 시계서 문에.
Says the priests could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of God.
그분이 그 자리에 계셨기 때문에 그분께서 예배 모임 인물로 쓰고 있다.
The glory of the Lord that filled the temple was so heavy that the priests couldn't even stand up.
그분께서 예배 모임 인물로 쓰고 있다가
The New Testament adds to our understanding of glory by using the Greek word doxa to describe God's glory, splendor or brilliance.
예토르스 사무로 비기디도 자이에 비게스 오라 독사 게스 디자스 수세 무르 디자 독사 게스 오니로 예바이 게스 미예메 노데스 시게스 디테제스 게스 시게스 리루세
Through Christ, this glory is now in us.
크리스토르 자이에 오라 우무바데웨
I recently read these thoughts from a writer named Josh McClellan, which helped me put the weightiness of God's glory into perspective.
어찌 보면 조지 맥클레멘에게서
He says, to experience the glory of God is to feel the weight of God. To know God's glory is for Him to be heavy upon us.
그분께서 그분께서 자기의 수시를 요해 God's
glory displaces other priorities in our lives.
그분께서 자기의 수시를 왜 그분의 수시를 시기하도록 그분께 미해 토 생각하여
To know God and His glory is to let the purposes of God be the weight that guides the direction of our lives.
그분께서 자기의 시계에 수수해 그분께서 하늘 나쁜 하늘 그게 수수시 수수시에 무수수고 그분께 눈 첫 하기는 수수분께 눈 내시 계획에서 비고 눈 뜨기로 해
God and all that drives God in the pursuit of His own glory must be weightier to us than everything else in our lives.
그분께서 그분 앞에 대기를 그분께서 무엇을 시계에 무엇을 초대해서 수수수고 계속 받게 되겠고 그분께서 내시 통치를 모시고
I want you to consider what is the weight or what are the weights that drive your life?
아무것도 없으면 대체적으로 거기에서 그렇게 누구 더 세게 되다.
As I read through my great-grandparents' writings, it's clear to me that the purposes of God was the weight that guided their life.
아, 앞장으로 제 그것을 하고 맺으면 제 이것을 그것을 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 그것
Perhaps you don't know, but many people try to discourage them from leaving for
Nagaland.
They said, stay at home, there's so much work to be done in America. Why do you need to go to Nagaland?
And
then upon arrival in India, the mission committee advised them not to come to Kohima. Dr. Rivenberg said it would be far too difficult.
Dr. Rivenberg positively, you support us rest of the
In fact, he wrote a letter forcefully opposing them, saying that they would never learn the language on Dharma.
Well, listen, it took me
said that the Angami language was the most difficult in Asia, if not the world.
Angami he
especially said that Mabel would never learn the language. He made it clear it wasn't anything personal, but he had already seen two other families try to come and not make it, and he just wanted to, he was concerned for them and didn't want them to fail.
So, Dr.
They humbly appealed to the mission board and eventually were allowed to come to Kohima.
There are people who are not going to be able to come to Kohima.
And the weight of the purposes of God to redeem and restore the Naga peoples to himself continued to propel my great grandparents' heart in God's eternal story. It propelled them into scripture translation, not only into Angami but other tribal languages. Christian education, as well as forming the first Naga-led family council, which is now the NBCC. But ultimately, it was to equip and send forth now the men and women as partners and fellow laborers in ministry.
There is a lot of people who are not going to be able to do this.
Dear sisters and brothers, can you see that there is a weighty importance to bearing God's image? As a follower of Christ, each of you contain and reflect God's glory and splendor. There is a weightiness and impact of His glory through you that this world needs to experience. Now where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, and we who with unveiled faces all reflect the Lord's glory, we are being transformed into His likeness with ever-increasing glory which comes from the Lord who is the Spirit.
Corintia tinie se pertinie nu pertinie nu ne trebuie să o mână profesor am hie si o nu se rupuzo nu ne cu rupu că vara o pe car staia mă rog pe teri nu zi e iasă să mă li trăvamă nu am nu ia deja de ei ne cu zaiu mă voli ne cu rupu rupusu nu uți te vie zaiu o nu zaiu pe
Another translation from Greek says, "We with unveiled faces are looking as in a mirror at the glory of God." A historical insight is that ancient mirrors were made of brass, bronze, copper, silver, and hammered flat. The ancient city of Corinth was famous for its production of brass mirrors. Most likely what Paul was referring to in this message. Ancient mirrors also tarnished easily and need constant polishing, so the pebble stone was often attached to it. After polishing, however, when the sun hit the mirror, the radiant golden reflection would cover your face. Similarly, by placing ourselves in the light of the gospel and by receiving the glory of Christ who shines there, we are transformed into the likeness of the same glory that shines on us, Jesus. As we continue growing in Christ and His likeness, this transformation process produces a glory into our lives, which is intended to increase as we continue to reflect and reveal His heart to the world. So who am I through the lens of that story? How do I unveil my calling? As a Christian, there's something weighty and significant to your life in Christ. We've been pursued, set apart, and commissioned to reveal and reflect Christ to the world. And He's given you something unique to you through your relationship with Him that He compels you to offer. Simply put, your calling is what God specifically created you for, to reveal and reflect to this world for His kingdom and His glory.
Keep us to do the case of the law. que te lo fue, no quiere no ver, solo no te quiero, solo sabía ese ver.
And as part of that, God has chosen you and given you a part to play that is yours and yours alone.
Musulu, nerbit sa tigili, hoko, nerbit sa tigili, sige sa kundi, kundi sa sa wala ba.
John 15:16 says, you did not choose me, I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that fruit should abide. So whatever you ask the Father in my name, He will give to you. There's also an extraordinary purpose for your life in Christ. Ephesians 2:10 says, for we are God's masterpiece or workmanship. He's created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do the good things or good works He planned for us long ago. Your part in God's story is to be your greatest joy. Philippians 2:13 says, God is producing in you both the desire and the ability to do what pleases Him. You know, the early missionaries to the Naga tribes were just regular people like you and me. In fact, my great-grandfather grew up as a poor immigrant farmer, struggling to make ends meet as a child. It just shows that God can use all of us for His purposes. It doesn't matter our background. As for the early missionaries, God put His desire for Naga land and the Naga people in their hearts.
My great-grandparents
viewed their years in Naga land and relationships with the Nagas as the most rewarding and fulfilling of their lives. I want to share some words from my great-grandmother. As she was leaving Nagaland, she wrote, the memory of the many girls and women I've learned to know and love count as my dear personal friends in Nagaland will be cherished by me to my dying day. Looking back over the years of our life among these wonderful tribes, I think of when I have traveled with Joe into a dozen language areas as the most strenuous yet most enjoyable experience that ever came my way.
我今天听到你这么问，啊，现在就是我们那个五十六，而那给你的这，给路， suko saje hude se hibo hibo suko saje hude se nu sewa anu ku zeni joseph zeni nu ni die ki ni ke se suko se ki ke ki se puya de se na ku nu hude se unye se de ni ku ke ni ko ke se ka ke hude ke ka ke ni ko i bu se ke se ka ke ni se jo.
I found this quote from my great grandfather. He said, "Our main purpose would be to let our light shine in some small corner for the Master." We bring the glory of God in into these roles.
Che per tutti tutti chiesi non vedo che mi possa dire su su se forse non ha può un ha non vedo che mi possa dire se forse.
We also are shaped by assignments where God sends us to let our callings be felt.
Ci sono un vedo che sono ha può su non vedo che mi possa dire su su se via.
We also go through seasons of life. And that's when the expression of our calling may shift in focus according to opportunities and limitations due to life circumstances. In these areas, we represent God by revealing His heart in the personal areas of influence where you live, work, and play. I want to say a few more things about seasons of life. Since this is a women's session, I want to speak to the women right now. I've experienced what I'm about to share with you. Women, especially when you're bringing up young children, we can find it hard to believe we're playing an irreplaceable role in a great story.
When you look in the zip, oh, excuse me, you look in the zip, say, share it with you.
Dirty nappies, cooking, cleaning, disciplining strong-willed children are often not the parts that we long to play, and we can get weary. But with God's clear view of His larger story, our acts of love, sacrifice, time, and energy are of utmost importance. Every relationship, every child, small disciple, every day is crafted by our loving God. The faithfulness to do what He's laid before you is a testimony to your faith that He's up to more than we can see or imagine in this world. As we are dependent on Christ, His glory in us will be expressed in all of our roles, our assignments, and seasons of life. And yet, we are also fragile vessels. We read. We read about God's glory in 2 Corinthians 3, but in 2 Corinthians 4, he goes on to say that we contain the glory and splendor of Christ in jars of clay. These vessels are simple, used for everyday purposes, fragile, and even
cracked.
Yet they can burst with the glory of God.
Que tem um pesadelo, eu não lhe arrependo.
Why do you think he describes us this way, just after describing how much glory and splendor we possess? Our frailty keeps us grounded in grace. Our complete and total reliance on Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit as we face our own limitations, sin, and brokenness. Growing in our love and in our dependence on Christ takes us deeper into becoming a vessel. So how do we live out our calling?
So what do we do? It's
simple. John 7:37-38 says, Jesus stood up and cried out, "If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water."
在昨天的时候，约翰听见，现在听见，现在他看，努努念，耶稣写把耶稣给，在那个里面，阿贝那个里面，阿贝那个阿贝那个里面，他从那时候负责这里，我们努努努，给儿子，就是给你，就是不管了，这个。
We need to be drinking daily of the Lord. We're spending time in His Word, in prayer, His presence, and with other believers. The way we live out our calling is to be in relationship with Jesus. Then from this place of being filled by the Lord, we respond. His living waters are able to flow from our lives. In loving God, doing what pleases Him, performing acts of service and love to other
people.
This will be the natural overflow of our love for Him. And I promise that as Christ pours His glory and splendor through you, you will find that serving Him is your greatest joy because it was what you were created for. You were created to be a vessel for His glory. I want to close with a few thoughts about leaving a legacy. When we remember people who impacted us, we don't so much remember what they did, but we remember how they loved. God expresses His love for each of us
uniquely.
And it's ultimately Christ's love that penetrates people's hearts and meets people's deepest needs.
되게 좁혀 이게 서로 그것이 되게 매우 이어서 내 무야시 그렇게 키워서 그것을 때
무세요.
First Corinthians 13 says, if we have all the gifts and all the knowledge but haven't love, we gain nothing.
그렇게 크게 그리스의 모든 게 방법에 떼버리기 앞에 떼시버리기 내게 피해서 모여 걱정해서 앞으로 이렇게 이만 먹고
19 years ago, 5 months before my grandmother went to the home of the Lord, I was able to finally visit Nagaland.
Did you get the food? Oh, the lucky. I saw, it's so sick. Oh, the
I was the first one to visit since my great grandparents left in 1948.
I saw, I'm pretty good.
I felt like I was able to glimpse the peace of heaven. Because I met elderly people like this, who knew my great grandparents. And I saw a legacy that was written in human hearts. Second Corinthians 3:3 says, you show that you are alive in Christ, the result of our ministry. Written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts. Friends, each of you is an original masterpiece. He created you to impact this world in a way that no others can, in the lives of your family, friends, and all others who touch your life. I want to leave you with this last picture. I want you to consider the beautiful hand-woven shawls. There are many designs and styles, all woven with great care and
artistry.
Now I want you to think of your life as a weaving. God is weaving the threads of your life into a beautiful design. No thread of experience, good or bad, is wasted. We must trust that God, who is our leader, knows what He's doing with us. Though your task today may seem rather insignificant, God sees the end of the
story.
Where people from every tribe, tongue, and nation will be worshiping at his
throne.
And in God's story, each of you is your own thread in God's kingdom design. When you're finally face to face with the Lord, you will see the finished work of His
story.
And you'll appreciate how skillfully and beautifully He has woven your own unique thread into His glorious design.
Musa,
Yeah,